Welcome back to Doctrinal Discussion Corner. Today we are looking at the gift of the Holy Spirit, and this is the portion that a lot of people have misused, a lot of people have kind of criticized, a lot of people have abused the gift of the Holy Spirit. And as the Lord was speaking to me about the gift of the Holy Spirit, the speaking in tongues, that we should talk about it today. I want to bring it to our notice. There are so many importance of the baptism of the Holy Spirit. There's so many important uses and how to obey God according to His word is by the help of the Holy Spirit. I welcome you today to the Doctrinal Discussion Corner. This is Evangelist Catherine Favor Nathan. He's Catherine Favor Worldwide Evangelical Outreach. Our topic is baptism in the Holy Ghost, speaking in tongues. We know our emotions should be, who am I in Christ? When we talk about the gift of the Holy Spirit, you have to consider your emotion. Who are you attached to? You know, you're speaking in tongue. Why are you speaking in tongue? Is it motivated? You want to know. Some people kind of learn it. They want to train people, teach people how to speak in tongue. You can't teach somebody how to speak in tongue. It is a gift. It's the Holy Spirit that gives the gift of the Holy Spirit, okay? So we have a motive. We speak in tongues. What are our motives? Do you want Jesus to be glorified in that speaking in tongues? The purpose of speaking in tongues, and which is where it comes from, you have to accept Jesus before you can be baptized in the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit seals us that we are the children of God. So what are your choices? Do you choose to accept a lie? Even when you know it is true, people fabricate tongues. People criticize tongues. Do you want to join and condemn people that... join people that condemn speaking in tongues, or you want to join people that kind of fabricate tongues? You want to join people that make up lies in the name of gift of the Holy Spirit, speaking in tongues? This is the last days. This is the end time. The Antichrist is fighting against the church, and these are the areas I know that a lot of false tongues have been poured out, wrong spirits have been poured out, deceptions and lies of the enemy have been poured out. That is to criticize the church, that is to criticize the word of God, and that is to kind of, people kind of abuse the use, the gift of the Holy Spirit, knowing that the Holy Spirit is a person. He is God. He is the Spirit of the Most High God, and He is the Spirit of God in the church today. And when you are baptized in the Holy Spirit, it kind of signifies by your speaking in tongues. A lot of people are afraid. They have received it, but they are afraid to speak in tongues. But this is the topic I'm bringing today for us to not stop if you are already gifted in the Holy Spirit. I use the word not stop speaking in the Holy Spirit, okay? Because it is the will of God. You want to consider, what is the will of God in my life? Do you choose to give up the willpower? Do you want to give up speaking in tongues because of what people criticize? Or you want to give up a baptism of the Holy Spirit? Maybe you are praying for the gift of the Holy Spirit. Maybe because of what people are saying, I don't want to speak again. You are the one losing, because the enemy, the Antichrist, we call it Antichrist. Anything that is of Christ is against it. So they manipulate, they mislead. They bring so many, like a lot of us on online ministry, they bring up a lot of false videos just to criticize. People criticize speaking in tongues, the work of the Holy Spirit, and condemn and criticize the church. Brethren, this is the last days. You cannot do without the Holy Spirit, okay? So we want to go back to the scriptures. Signs of the Holy Spirit, we see in the book of Acts of Apostles, and we look at chapter 3, verse 3, and there appeared unto them, that's chapter 2, verse 3, please. Acts of Apostles chapter 2 verse 3, and there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them. That was the day the Holy Spirit came down, because Jesus made a promise and that He will send us the Comforter, the Holy Spirit. He will teach us all things. He will help us. He will even help our infirmities, the areas we are struggling. This is the Holy Spirit duty, and that's the promise Jesus gave us. I encourage everybody, wherever, all over the world, do not misuse the gift of the Holy Spirit. Do not talk down on the gift of the Holy Spirit. Do not look down. The Holy Spirit has a lot of duties in our life. If you say you have given your life to Jesus Christ, you are sealed with the Holy Spirit. And when you are sealed with the Holy Spirit, it's because you need the Holy Spirit. You cannot serve the Lord without the Holy Spirit. So many things are going on in the face of the earth. Many churches are being criticized. The gospel of Jesus Christ is being criticized. But I want you to know, you that know the God you serve, you that understand what your salvation is all about in Christ Jesus, you that know that you are redeemed out of darkness into the marvelous light of Jesus, you know the importance of the Holy Spirit. Without the Holy Spirit, the gift of God cannot manifest. So we want to flow today. Verse 4 of Acts of Apostles chapter 2 said, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. It's the Holy Spirit that gives utterance. It's the Holy Spirit that fills up. For me to stand to preach today, for me to be able to speak today, it is the utterance of the Holy Spirit. It is the Holy Spirit that speaks through to for me to us to speak about this topic. So for you to serve God effectively, you need the Holy Spirit. And a lot of people, I've been praying for the gift of the Holy Spirit. Like I said earlier, many are afraid. They've already been given, but some people feel they are ashamed. No, you cannot. When they start bubbling, the Bible says, from that bowl shall flow rivers of living water. It will flow like rivers of living water. Do not quench the Holy Spirit. That's what Thessalonians told us, okay? So as we flow with the gift of the Holy Spirit, we look at the external manifestation that we see in Acts of Apostles. A lot of people were filled with the Holy Spirit and with different kinds of tongues they were speaking. Also, in the house of Cornelius in Acts of Apostles chapter 10, and you know, when Peter was sent to the house of Cornelius by prophecy, he went there. So in Acts of Apostles chapter 11 verse 15, and Paul reported, he said, and as I began to speak, the Holy Ghost fell on them as on us at the beginning, like in the beginning, in the day of Pentecost. He said the Holy Ghost fell on them, like in the beginning on them, just as it was on us, okay? Then remembered I the word of the Lord, how that he said, John indeed baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost. Brothers and sisters, in these last days, we need the Holy Spirit. Do not let the media deceive you. Do not let the force that are poured out in the face of the earth, criticizing the gospel of Jesus Christ, criticizing our faith, do not let anything, you know, make you not to speak in tongue. If you are yearning for it, if you are desiring for the gift of the Holy Spirit by speaking in tongue, if you are requesting this from God, do not stop requesting, because once you are asked, you are given. You have to walk by faith. Know that He is given to you. Do not, I repeat, do not join people that learn how to speak in tongue. You cannot learn. The Bible says it shall flow rivers of living water from thy bowel, that you start speaking. Sometimes some people will start with like two-letter words, three-letter words, until gradually flow like rivers of water, okay? So please, I encourage us. We need the Holy Spirit in these last days. Do not look at what people are saying and criticizing, okay? So meaning interpretation by Peter, you know, the Holy Spirit do a lot of stuff, but I'm going to jump in some until I get to the main importance of the gift of the Holy Spirit. Acts of Apostles chapter 2, if you look at, take your time, you can read from verse 14 to 40, but I kind of took about four verses for us to look at how Peter explained to the people when they were speaking in tongues. People from different parts of the world, they were like, what are these people saying? They thought they were drunk, but Peter stood up and was able to clarify them. Hey, this is the promise. Our Lord Jesus have promised us that he will send the Holy Spirit. So I'm reading verse 16 of Acts of Apostles chapter 2. But this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel in Joel. And it shall come to pass in the last days, said God, I will pour out of my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. 18 said, and on my servant and on my handmaidens I will pour out in those days of my spirit, and they shall prophesy. I want to speak here. People criticize sometimes we women that preach. There are some men that say, oh, women are not supposed to speak, or women are not supposed to preach. What did the Bible say? And I want to understand, brethren, please, who was the first preacher? It was a woman, Mary Magdalene, because when she got there, the tomb was already open. The angel helped her to open the tomb. She was able to go preach the gospel. So don't let anybody chunk you down when it comes to the things of God, when it comes to the work of God. The handmaiden, men and women, are going to be filled with the Holy Spirit, and the Spirit of God is going to use you to do what God wants you to do, because I want to speak to somebody. From when God created you, there are so many gifts God has put in you. Of those gifts that God has put in you, the Holy Spirit will help you for you to bring out those gifts to be able to function. So for you to receive the Holy Spirit, for you to be baptized in the Holy Spirit, is for you to be efficient in the things of God, is for you to serve God according to His will, and for you to be led and be strengthened. So many things you can do, we are going to do with the Holy Spirit. Anybody that says they are creating so many teachings and doctrines, that is not of the Holy Spirit. You cannot create it. The scripture is already there. As you obey the word of God, as you teach the doctrine of Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit is there. Without the Holy Spirit, you cannot function. So also Jesus could not function without the Holy Spirit. Remember, he was baptized. When he was about 30, he was baptized, and the Holy Spirit came down upon him, and he was declared that this is my beloved son, a woman well pleased, hearing him. You see what I'm saying? So the Holy Spirit had to come down. All the while Jesus was going through his training, you know, growing up, the Holy Spirit was there. He learned a lot, but when he came to the time of functioning, the Holy Spirit was able to use him to work effectively. Just as you and I, we can be able to serve God effectively by the guidance and the direction of the Holy Spirit. Do not let anybody criticize your speaking in tongues. Do not let anybody kind of talk you down or chunk you down in desiring to speak in tongues, okay? It's a gift. You deserve it as a child of God, because you are sealed with the Holy Spirit. It has to manifest by that baptism, okay? So verse 30 of Acts of Apostles chapter 38 and 39, I'm reading right now. He said, then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sin, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is unto you, and to your children, and to all that are afar off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. Because I know one thing, the Bible says, many are called, few are chosen. Many are called to do the work of God. Many are called. When you receive Jesus, wherever you are, you hear the gospel of Jesus Christ, you are called. It's left to you to accept Jesus. It's left for you to say no. Because when you accept him, you are sealed with the Holy Spirit. And when you accept Jesus as Lord, you are going to be baptized by the Holy Spirit, so you can be able to serve God effectively. Okay? So we are going to understand something. There are so many false teachers. In this last day, the Lord has been revealing so many things. The God of this age manipulating doctrines. The God of this age criticizing churches. The God of this age fighting against the body of Christ. The occultic world, they create so many systems, create so many teachings. When the Lord gave me a message, I'll be bringing them one after the other. So that for the church in this last days, get yourself prepared that what the way things are happening now is going to get worse. But in the Holy Spirit, you can be able to stand and do exploit for the Lord. Because as the last days go, people are falling so sick. So many things are happening in the body of Christ because of money. Because of money, people devise so many things to make money in the gospel of Jesus Christ. So they fabricate systems because of money to deceive people. Please do not let this deter you from serving God in truth and in the spirit, okay? Do not let the enemy kind of push you out of faith when it comes to you serving God because of what people say, what people criticize. I am not moved at all. I remember when the Lord granted me grace, go online, start preaching. I struggled a little bit. When I started, there were so many people that criticized me. You must not preach. At a point, even some people came to my page. Then I was kind of studying and learning how to function on Facebook and on YouTube and all that. They would come to my page. They post so many things, you know. But God granted me grace. I was able to kind of maneuver the page and be able to remove, you know, put a stand so that nobody can be able to post on my page. They were really against me, against women preaching. They were really against me. So I want to speak to a lot of us, especially like some of our female sisters that are so, you know, you are kind of scared. People say women cannot do anything. The Holy Spirit will lead you. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. So I want to encourage us. Do not say, okay, I'm not gonna pray for Holy Spirit to be filled in tongues. It's your right. You deserve it, and when you receive it, you can be able to serve God faithfully. So I want to encourage us. We need the Holy Spirit. And there was a video somebody posted. They were criticizing Christians speaking in tongues. They were criticizing, but there's something we really need to understand when it comes to speaking in tongues. God is not an order of confusion. There's a way Apostle Paul kind of separated it. two or three people can be speaking in tongue, one person should have interpretation of tongue. That's how gift of tongue goes. It has interpretation. There's a purpose it goes. We cannot be speaking like crowd of crazy people just speaking and speaking. If there's orderliness in speaking in tongues. A lot of you know, most of the time, I don't really speak in tongue much on the screen because I know some might not understand, but I know what I'm speaking. What God gives me utterance. I pray more on my private, in my private room. I pray more in tongues than speaking in words because there are so many things the Lord wants us to understand, okay? Excuse me. So, spiritual gifts. I want us to go to 1 Corinthians chapter 12. There are so many things there that the church needs to know. There are so many things there, brothers and sisters, you need to know. I know a lot of us are discovered by false teachers. A lot of us are discovered by false prophets. Many come with lies for deception of money. I remember I was taking a walk. I don't know if I shared it in prophetic prayer. And it's also a message that the Lord has given me because the Lord gave me this for me to see what was going on, okay? When you have the Holy Spirit and you continue to function in the Holy Spirit, let the Holy Spirit lead you. You have gifts that the Lord will not use. Let me give you a clear example. I pray more in tongues. In my private room, I pray more in tongues than speaking in words. And when I speak in tongues, the Lord grants me grace with scriptures in tongues as well, which makes me function very well. So in that morning, I woke up. I was on vacation. I went on vacation to Nigeria. So spiritually, the Lord opened my eyes. I had an encounter with a lady. And with this lady, something happened, but I was able to get the seed that this lady was trying to sow. So many things, other things happened. So in that morning, I didn't plan to take a walk, but I just found myself just dressing up to take a walk. My husband's like, "Are you taking a walk?" I said, "Yeah, that's what I've been seeing. It's like the Lord wants me to take a walk." So I dress up. I got ready to take a walk. Where I saw the lady in this in a vision, because I woke up, the Lord opened my spiritual eye. I saw the beginning of the estate, the beginning of the street, okay? So I took a walk. So coming back at the place, at the beginning of the estate, this is physical, this is not spiritual anymore. This lady kind of called me, that the Lord led her, she greeted, I'm a very friendly person openly, I greeted her and said, "Hey," she started that the Lord have led her to me, that I'm adding weight, I'm bloated, that I'm doing exercise, that people are using astral projection, bewitching me, that I'm a very nice person, and that I give people a lot of things. The people I give stuff are the people that are bewitching me, and they keep blowing me in spirit, that it happened to her in her marriage, and she talked about her marriage. This lady just kept going and going and going. I said to my mother, I said, "God, thank you for me to see what the spirit of the devil is doing in the body of Christ." So she was going on and on and on that God has called her, that she go places, that she help a lady in marriage, and whatever they give her, that's how she live by, that God has called her, and she goes, she talk to people give her money, and that's how she just kept going and going and going. I was just listening to her. Brethren, in everything this lady said, she never called the name of Christ. In everything she was kind of, I will use the word, blabbing. She didn't talk about Jesus saving. She didn't talk about in the name of Jesus. She just did not call the name of Jesus. I was like, whoa. You know, she was just talking and talking. She said so many things, that looking at me, that people are doing this to me, people are doing that to me, and that's why this is happening, and that's why this is happening, because she saw me, she felt I live in that estate, and maybe I have a big house there or something, maybe, I don't know. But she continued. I said, "Okay, when she's done," I said, "Are you done?" She said, "Yes." I said, "When God called you into the ministry, did you talk to the Lord to kind of guide you so that you know the area God is calling you? You can't just see people. Because of what you see physically, they walk by sight, not in spirit. So you see somebody physically, you started talking about bloating, you started talking about being bewitched, you started talking about astral projection, you start talking about giving to people, you start sowing seed of marriage, so my husband is the one bewitching me. How dare you criticize the people, condemn people's way of lifestyle in the name of preaching the gospel, breaking marriages, sowing dirty seed in people's marriage, and you want money out of it?" When I started, honestly, there was a way she act, you know, the way she looked at, I I looked at her, and because when I started, we were looking at her eyeball to eyeball. So eyeball to eyeball, when I started talking, she moved her eyes. And the way she moved her eyes, like, oh my goodness, I got the wrong person. They got me. So when I said, look, woman, if you, I'm telling you, brethren, I am not criticizing, but you know, this is someone that the men looking at her outwardly, like some people believe that they tie their head 24/7. I'm not condemning anybody. Please don't get me wrong here. People believe tying their head 24/7, you know, no juries and all that. They feel superficially outwardly they are Christians. So this was the mindset people might think, just the way she was dressed. I said, ma'am, look, you are talking about somebody you don't know. You don't know me. All this thing you are saying, you got the wrong person. I'm a teacher. I teach people under the school of theology. So this thing you are talking now, where does it quantify somebody giving their life to Christ? And you yourself, you don't even know your calling. You are just a petty beggar. You begging in the name of prophesying. That is not prophecy. Number two, you are sowing dirty seed, breaking people's marriage. So I was, immediately I started, it's like she noticed I was hitting to where she was going. You know, spiritually the Holy Spirit now took over. I started talking to her about herself. You are just a petty thief. In the name of prophesying, you reach out, stealing from people. And you call yourself a Christian. So all these things you're talking about, you didn't call the name of Jesus Christ. Immediately, I said that, she started to take a walk. I said, hey, don't leave. We need to finish this here. So when she was going, I raised my voice, because I kind of bring my voice up so that she can hear me afar. All of a sudden, when I said, you did not in any area call the name of Jesus Christ. Speak to me. I want to be saved. Tell me if I'm supposed to be saved. Speak to me about Jesus Christ. She got angry. She said, all the while you have been calling Jesus, what has he done for you? Brethren, this is the mark. You see, when they create their own teaching, when they create their own system, it's outside Christ. Anything that is not of Christ, the Holy Spirit is not there. People are creating it. So if you should ask me now, with this person, she have deceived so many people. She have broken so many marriages. You can believe this person. When you see this person, a prayer gathering, definitely you will see them blabbing tongues. And they will be deceiving people. So this is just an example. People have abused the gift of God. People have abused it for business and have afflicted people with so many diseases, broken home. If I'm somebody that, you know, listens to side talk, or maybe I don't have confidence in myself. Okay, I was okay. I'm bloating. I'm adding weight. I'm doing this. I'm doing that. I'll be worried of myself. Brethren, let us be very careful. The spirit of Antichrist have his agents. The enemy use so many people to criticize the gospel of Jesus Christ. If I'm not a born again, and I see this person, definitely when you tell me anything about Jesus, I might kind of break your head, you know, because of what that person did. And for example, the home that she already broke, when somebody see any other person that, you know, say in the name of Jesus, definitely they start criticizing, they start condemning. So this is an example. I use myself as an example. I thank God always. God always use so many things to teach me, and I always like to use myself as an example. And when I saw this, I see this as a problem in the body of Christ. In so many areas, people lack knowledge, people lack understanding. We are about what this gift is all about, have to walk with the Holy Spirit. So it's an example. I've just used that country as an example. It's happened here in the United States. It happened so many parts of the world. I've come across so many people that were giving false prophecy, false messages, and there were a lot of things were used to mess up their home and their family in the name of the Spirit of God leading them. That is where I'm teaching today, for us not to be moved by liars on the platform. Okay, so the gift, the spiritual gift, we look at the book of Acts of 1 Corinthians chapter 12. I'm reading 8. He said, for to one is given by the Spirit the word of wisdom, to another the word of knowledge by the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another the gift of healing by the same Spirit, to another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another discerning of spirits, to another diverse kinds of tongue, and to another the interpretation of tongue. But all this worked that walketh at one and the same self, same spirit, dividing to every man severally as he will. The gift of God is given to you as you have accepted Jesus as Lord. As Peter said, you must accept Jesus for you to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. And you are already sealed by this Holy Spirit. So you see this 9 gifts that I've just named. Somebody might have about 4 or 5, depending. And the Holy Spirit will be using people, you know. And when you are in prayer, when you're speaking in tongues, you see these gifts start coming out. To another, the working of miracles, and to prophet, and another, prophecy, to another. People have been misled by this prophecy because the Lord have people with gift of prophecy. It's a ministry, but it's been abused. Just like this lady standing there, said the Lord led her to me. The Lord want her to tell me this. These are fabricated prophecy that come that is for destruction. So many have been deceived by this prophecy. I encourage people, whatever you hear, go to the scriptures, pray over it. If it's what God has said, pray over it, Father, confirm, because the Bible says from the mouth of 2 or 3 witnesses, he will confirm his word, okay? So do not let people deceive you by all this. You yourself, you deserve the gift of the Holy Spirit. You need the gift of the Holy Spirit. You have the Holy Spirit. You can function with the Holy Spirit, and the Lord can speak to you as well. So this is for us to know. 28 of 1 Corinthians 12 says, and God has set some in the church. First, apostles, right? Secondly, prophets. Thirdly, teachers. After that, miracles. Then gift of healing, helps. Government, diversity of tongues. There are so many offices the Holy Spirit can use us into. Talk and look at, even in government diversities, there are areas the Holy Spirit can use us. So this is a gift that we're supposed to be having. But why is a problem today is that many people are misleading the church. And now he said, are all apostles, are all prophets, are all teachers, are all workers of miracles, have all the gifts of healing, do all speak with tongues, do all interpret? It's a question Paul is asking. We will go down to see. Must everybody be prophets? Must everybody be miracle workers? Must everybody be teachers? Must everybody be counselors? Must everybody be miracle workers? You must find your place. That's why I was speaking to this woman. You must find your place. Must everybody be evangelist? I'm an evangelist. I know the office of evangelist can do a lot. You know, under the office of an evangelist, you cannot be everywhere. That's what Apostle Paul is teaching. So many people are deceived. Many people misinterpret the gift of the Holy Spirit. Many misjudge the gift of the Holy Spirit. Many are misusing it now for business money. I use myself as an example. Excuse me. I use myself as an example. I am somebody, I pray a lot in tongues. I want to give us this mystery. And it's a mystery that people don't know. When you speak in tongues, you take the devil unaware. The demons don't understand the language of tongues. I like to pray more in tongues in my private, because when you speak in tongues, you'll be able to interpret, you'll be able to understand, and you'll be able to flow further than where you are. But when you kind of start to suppress the Holy Spirit, you cannot be able to flow. There was a time in our God's prayer group, Generals, there's a mission moving towards school of theology. The Lord is calling a lot of people, you know, for us to train people in school of theology and plant churches. So as we were flowing in that prayer, I was really praying that the Lord said, come, let me show you. As I was speaking in tongues, I saw that a lot of demons that were gathered, they did not understand. The Lord said, let's take them unawares because they don't know what is going on in the spiritual realm. And the Lord showed me so many things, and that really gave me a deeper insight. The more you speak in tongues, the demons get confused. You take the devil unaware. It's a language the devil will not understand. I'm not talking about the type of tongue people fabricate. I'm not talking about tongues from the kingdom of darkness. That's not the tongue I'm talking about. The Holy Spirit speaking in tongues. Because when you speak in tongues, you are spiritually warfare. Those of us that have the spiritual insight, you find yourself with sword drawn. You are killing, you are cutting asunder. While you speak in tongues, you see yourself as a warrior in the spiritual realm. The kingdom of darkness don't know. You take them unawares. That's why it's very, very important when you are already feeling the Holy Spirit, always speak in tongues. If you desire it, somebody want to ask me, because I can discern how you receive it. You might be, you already have to ask God for the gift of tongues. Say, Lord, baptize me in the Holy Spirit. You'll be in the room, you are praying, you are worshiping, right? As the song is going, you see that pressure coming. Don't stop that pressure. When that pressure comes, you keep singing. You don't know the word to just open your mouth, speak any word that comes, and that's the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Some people, when they come to this level, they stop, they get scared. You don't quench the Holy Spirit, you see? So that's why it's like some people, they are struggling, you know, say that they are not able. No, when you ask, God gives. You just have to start flowing by when you are worshiping God, when you are singing, and you sing it from your heart. The Holy Spirit takes over because you've already requested to be filled with the Holy Spirit. As you are singing, the power of God will keep flowing. You'll find yourself singing one song. You are praying. As you are praying, you don't know which word. Another word keep coming to your mouth. That is the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Just go ahead and speak it. That is being baptized in the Holy Spirit. And when you flow, you might start with one letter word. As you speak it more, two letter word. As you speak more, you start speaking more. The more you speak more, you see the gift, you see energy, you see the gift keep manifesting in you. So I encourage brethren, the gift of the Holy Spirit is very important. Do not quench it. Do not quench it. Interpretation is required. Now, there's something we must understand in a gathering. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, 27 and 28 said, if any man speak in an unknown tongue, let it be by two or the most by three, and that by cause, and let one interpret. There must be an interpretation where two or three people are speaking in tongues. One person interprets what they are speaking, because you can't just be speaking. I've seen so many people, they keep speaking in tongues. It's like a sounding cymbal. It's like noisy. This one is speaking now, but many people are speaking. Speaking in tongues, there must be an interpretation. God is not an order of confusion. There must be orderliness when speaking in tongues. There must be an interpreter. Interpreter must be there. But if there be no interpreter, verse 28 of 1 Corinthians 14 said, but if there be no interpreter, let him keep silence in the church and let him speak to himself and to God. You see what I'm saying? So there was a period years back, I learned this. It was so interesting. Then I didn't know that there will be, you know, you have not really studied the scripture to know about interpretation. We were just worshiping and praying, and there was so many things were happening as we were speaking. As we were speaking in tongues, I was speaking. Another person was interpreting what I was saying. He was interpreting raw message from the government. I was speaking in tongues. She was interpreting it. As we were talking, you know, everybody would just keep quiet and they were listening. When I finished speaking in tongues, she just ended. That is how speaking in tongues goes. When people are gathered, one person should have interpretation of that tongue. God is not an order of confusion like what is happening today. And you see, people criticize speaking in tongues because it is not used orderly, it is not respected, and it's kind of misused, because you can speak in tongues, you don't just keep speaking anyhow, but in your own private prayer time, speak always in tongues, because your gift manifests more, okay? So people must, when you speak in tongues, let us speak with love. You know, you don't speak to show off that you can speak. Let it be for the purpose, for the love of God, for the glory of God, for edification, for, you know, yes, people will see you speak in tongues, but for you to flow in spirit. So let this be for love. I'll just take your time, read the book of 13, 1 Corinthians chapter 13. It really talk about love. You said 11 said, but when I was a child, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. We put away childish things. You know, in a garden of fellowship, you don't really want to just start acting like a child. This one is speaking over there. That person is speaking over there. Everybody's kind of speaking. There's confusion in the house. There must be an interpreter. You must be orderly. You must, and when you pray scripturally according to the word, because the Holy Spirit, when you are praying, the word of God you read, you will see those words. The Holy Spirit will go in there. It's inside of you. The Holy Spirit will bring them out. So do not quench speaking in tongues. Do not quench the Holy Spirit. So people is subject to abuse, like we see today. 1 Corinthians 14, look at, let me read 1 Corinthians 14, 20 to 26, 22 to 26. He said, wherefore, tongues are for sign, not to them that believe, but to them that believe not. But prophesying serveth not for them that believe not, but for them we believe. For people that don't believe to see you speak in tongues, they believe that, oh, God can speak through somebody. It's not like you are making it. That's how it's supposed to be, you know. But today, people really abuse it. They, you know, I've seen some preachers, they are teaching people how to speak in tongues. You don't teach people. You just guide them and pray for them. They keep putting words together. You can't put word in somebody's mouth. And sometimes, you know, there are some musicians, you can sing through tongues. Some musicians, they sing in tongue when they sing. When it get to that part, I don't speak it because it's their own tongue. And that's the way, that's me, okay? I like to speak my own tongues, okay? So people abuse speaking in tongue. Look at what 23 said. If therefore the whole church be come together into one place and all speak with tongues, and there come in those that are on land that don't know, or unbelievers, will they not say that you are mad? You see what I'm saying? Is that confusion in the body of Christ? Because people will see everybody speaking in tongues, or they criticize, or they condemn. They will say these people are mad because everybody is speaking in tongues. It must be orderly. 24 said, but if all prophesy, and there come in one that believeth not, or one on land, he is convinced of all, he is judge of all. Look at 25. Let me give you some break. I went too far for that. Let me explain. Verse 25 said, and God said the secret of their hearts and made manifest. So falling down on his face, he will worship God and report that God is in you of a truth. Now what I say here, when you are a person that you prophesy with, you're speaking in tongues, you prophesy to somebody, and if what you have spoken is of a truth, their heart will be convicted, they will return to God. You see, they repent and return to God. But somebody that's always speaking in tongues, people come around, oh, everybody's speaking in tongues. They say these people are mad. What are they talking about? Because people don't understand. Speaking in tongues must be done orderly, and there must be an interpreter. 26 said, how is he? 26, let me go down to 26 because of time. I really need to rush this, okay? So 26, verse 26 says something. He said, how is it then, brethren, when you come together, every one of you had a psalm, had a doctrine, had a tongue, had a revelation, had an interpreter. Let all things be done unto edifying, so that we edify and encourage us. We don't need to be confused. This one will be singing here. This one will be speaking in tongues. That one will be prophesying. That one will be jumping up and down. Let us be wise in our fellowship. Let us not be like people that have no orderliness. How do we edify each other? The Holy Spirit helps, okay? So it is important. Let me go down to the importance, because of time. Let me go down to the importance of the Holy Spirit. Please, brethren, I want you to take this. It is very important. If you are not speaking in tongues yet, you are born again, you already see with the Holy Spirit, and you have asked to speak in the Holy Spirit, you have asked, maybe you are afraid to speak when the power came over you. So you have to learn when you are worshiping. I said it earlier, I'm going to say it again. When you start worshiping, you are worshiping God and you are praying. The song keeps coming and coming. Mind you, you've been praying, Lord, I want you to fill me with the Holy Spirit. As the song is coming, just keep singing. And you are praying, maybe you are praying with the Spirit, just keep praying. At a point, you'll find that you get a rush inside your bowel. Just open your mouth and speak the word that come out. That is the baptism. The word, when it comes, it might be one letter word or two letter word. Just keep flowing. It will flow. Don't quench it. And when you grow from there, this is how you are filled with the Holy Spirit. Let nobody teach you what to word, how to speak in tongues. That is not what the Bible says, okay? Peter said, when he went to the house of Cornelius, he was praying for them. All of a sudden, the Holy Spirit came down and they were baptized. This is how it goes. Don't let nobody deceive you. So today, people are criticizing speaking in tongues. You know why? Because people are misunderstanding how the speaking in tongues goes. In a crowd where speaking in tongues go, it must be orderly. You don't see this person speaking, that person speaking, that person speaking. There must be an interpreter. Instead, if there's no interpreter, if somebody is speaking, keep quiet. Just pray in words. Use regular words and pray. But in your own private room, like I use myself as an example, I pray mostly in tongues because that's where I get a lot of what God wants to give me. Speaking in tongues, brethren, Satan does not understand it. Witches does not understand it. Demons does not understand it. It's a heavenly word. It's the word of God. It's the Holy Spirit's word given to every Christian. And it changes, it flows. It must not be one word. It flows. You might be speaking somebody's language. You might be speaking somebody from Israel. You might be speaking a language. I see a lady that was speaking in tongues. There was an Israelite there. This person had this person speaking in their own language. So it's a language when you speak it, and when what they understood, the Lord grant them grace to understand, that tongue was just praising God, how exalted God is. This is a language Satan cannot manipulate. So I encourage everyone, speak more in tongues in your private room. Don't go out and start speaking in tongues. People will say, what are you saying? We must be orderly. We must let us understand the scriptures. So importance of speaking in tongues, it's about eight. So it's about eight. Please let us know. Benefit of speaking in tongues is to give us the assurance that we have been baptized in the Holy Spirit. That is one. Number two, the benefit to speak in tongues together with gift of interpretation of tongues, you will get an interpretation. It's an opportunity for you to get interpretation of tongues. The more you speak in tongues, you must get interpretation. The word of God can never return to him void. The word of God is truth. So please, if you are kind of in this situation, you have so many questions, you can send me question, I will respond to you. That is one of the benefits for you together. When we come together, as we speak in tongues, like I said, two or three people, there will be an interpreter. There must be an interpreter for those tongues that are being spoken, okay? And one place is 1 Corinthians 14, 27 to 28. If anyone speak in tongues, let there be two or at the most three, each in turn, and let one interpret. You see what I'm saying? Let us understand. We speak in orderly so that we can get an interpreter. So, number three, the benefit is that tongues can enable us to communicate with others in a language that we have not learned. When we speak in tongues, that other person can interpret. That person can understand. Remember, in the Acts of Apostles, chapter 2, 11, on the day of Pentecost, we read how the people of Jerusalem were astonished and said, "We hear them speak in our own tongues." The wonderful works of God. That tongue was talking about the wonderful works of God. And God made them to understand that this is a sign that the baptism of the Holy Spirit have come upon the earth. And they were able to say, oh, these people are really edifying God in our own tongue, in our own language. So, brethren, speaking in tongues is very, very important. We have to draw close to God for him to baptize you, if you have not received, for him to baptize you. We have an example of this in Acts of Apostles chapter 2, 11, on the day of Pentecost. We read how the people of Jerusalem were astonished and said, "We hear them speak in our own tongues the wonderful works of God." Okay, another number four said the benefit is that tongues can edify us and increase our anointing. 1 Corinthians 14, 4 says, "He who speaks in a tongue edifies himself." This is a very powerful part. You speak in tongue, you edify yourself. You see, so many things will happen in your spiritual life. You will find yourself, edified. You edify himself. The word edify means to build oneself up. Speaking in tongue is one of the means that God has given to us to be filled with the Holy Spirit. Look at what Jude 1:20 said. "Build up yourself on your most holy faith, praying in Holy Ghost." When we pray in Holy Ghost, you see yourself being edified. The gifts in you come up, okay? So the benefit is that tongues enable us to pray according to the will of God. When you speak in tongues, Romans 8:26-27 said, "Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmity, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered." 27, "And he that searcheth the heart knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God." So when you speak in tongues, you find yourself praying. The Lord will take you many places. You find yourself praying up for people, praying according to his will. There are things that God will be revealing to you. You'll be praying over it. Be about the family, be about people, be about yourself, be about the church, be about one thing or the other. your spiritual eye will be opened, you'll be seeing so many things, you'll be praying over them. That's why it is important we receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. It's important we speak in tongues. I repeat again, do not look at people that are criticizing speaking in tongues. These are people, the people that walk by sight don't know what it is to walk in spirit. The carnal man will not understand the things of the spirit. And in this last day, the carnal men are the one proclaiming so many things against the church. And the spirit of Antichrist ginger so many false teachings that people are going to dirty deities, going to the devil to seek for power. So many things are happening in this end time. But I want to tell you, in the prayer of the Holy Spirit, we edify you, you break so many things. When God opens your spiritual eye, you find yourself with sword. You are fighting. You are breaking things. That's why it is important we all speak in tongues. Okay? The benefit is that tongues enable us to glorify God. John 16:15 said that the Holy Spirit would glorify him. In Acts 2:11, we all hear them speaking in our own tongues the wonderful work. Like I just said, when people from other languages, they saw the disciples, they were speaking in their own language. They said, oh, these people are glorifying God in our own language. So it enables us to glorify God. I'm telling you, so many times, most of the time I speak in tongues, I understand what I'm speaking. And this is how, the more you speak, this is how the Lord will be increasing your prayer life, revealing so many things to you. These are your spiritual gifts, all the nine gifts, spiritual gifts. You see them, using them wisely. You'll be able to hear the Holy Spirit guidance, and you do things according to the will of God. So, brethren, number 7, the benefit is that tongues enable us to be led by the Spirit. Sometimes you want to do something, you find yourself, you don't feel like doing that thing. You're just directed. The Holy Spirit guides us according to the will of God. We are led by the Holy Spirit when you speak my tongue. Romans 8:14 said, those who are led by the Spirit are sons of God. I am bringing this teaching. Please, brethren, do not let anyone deceive you. Do not let anybody mislead you. Speaking in tongues is very, very important. And I want you to understand that when you speak in tongues, I'm telling you, you are really communicating with God, okay? The last one, number 8, says, the benefit is that tongues enable us to grow spiritually. I am telling you, the more you speak in tongues, you find your spiritual growth. Even the word of God you read, the Holy Spirit will be taking those words, you see? So already read the book of Jude 1:20, building up yourself on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. Galatians 5, you all know I always quote Galatians chapter 5. If you look at verse 16, it says, walk in the Spirit and you will not fulfill the desires of the flesh. When we speak in tongues, a lot of it enables us to walk in spirit. And I pray in the name of Jesus that the Lord fill you with the Holy Spirit. Father God, I release as many of your children that have given their life to you and believe in you for tongues. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that you start to fill them, visit them in their prayer time with your word, and start to fill them with the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. I cancel and I break the hands of the enemy that create confusion in your mind in the name of Jesus. I cancel, I break the spirit hand of fear. For God, you have not given us the spirit of fear, spirit of power, love, and of a sound mind. Father Lord, I pray for your power. Take over this life with boldness and fill this life with your tongue in the mighty name of Jesus. So my brothers, my sisters, I encourage you, there are people criticizing speaking in tongues. Please, it is very important in these last days that we flow in tongues. So if you have not received it, ask, the Lord will give you. I'm telling you, the Lord is not partial, he's not selective of those that will speak in tongues. You deserve the speaking in tongues. It is your right. It is the promise of our Lord Jesus Christ. My Lord Jesus Christ, your Lord Jesus Christ is the promise. And that promise is certain for us in these last days. We need it. So as you have heard this message, I pray for the baptism of the Holy Spirit over your life to manifest in speaking in tongues in the mighty name of Jesus. So if you have any question, you feel there are some things I didn't touch, you can send me a message on WhatsApp, or you can just type out response, what you think, and I will respond to you. God bless you. So as I reach out to everybody on Monday. God bless you. Bye-bye.